Hi all, I'm Ankur Gupta. Hope all of you are doing well and welcome back to Analytics School. In the previous sessions, we had used Boolean mask indexing to filter our data frames and series based on their values. We created conditions, usually involving the comparison operators, resulting in Boolean series and passed them to the square bracket notation or the lock indexer to filter our data. In today's sessions, we will discuss about the query method, which enables us to make selection based on the values of the data frame or series. The query method is easier and more intuitive to filter the Pandas data frame or series. It is a good method to know about to make your subset selection more readable. Let's do some examples and understand how we can use query method to efficiently filter the Pandas data frame or series. Let's read the superstore dataset and see how the data looks like. I'm going to import Pandas and NumPy. I have read superstore dataset using read_csv. Let's see how many observations are there. There are 9,994 observations in superstore dataset and 20 columns. You can see the data types of all the variables in dtype variable. I have made some changes in the columns so that it is more readable. By using head method, we will get the top 5 records, and you can see here how the data looks like. We have order ID, order_date, ship underscore mode, customer ID, customer name, and sales quantity, discount and profit. The query method allows you to filter the data by writing the conditions as a string. The query method generally uses less syntax than Boolean mask indexing. Let's do an example where we will pass a logical condition in square bracket notation. And after that, we will further continue our discussion on the query method. So let's say we want to filter superstore dataset for sales greater than 100 using Boolean mask indexing. df_boolean df. I'm using here square bracket notation, and I'm saying sales greater than 100 reset_index drop equal to true copy. Let's see how many records are there in df_boolean dataset in comparison to our df dataset. So you can see here, there are 3,765 records and 20 columns. Don't you think so that this code looks a bit clumsy? With our data frame DF has been written twice next to one another. The query method has its own set of rules for what constitutes a correctly written logical condition within the string you pass it. This syntax only works within the query method and is not allowed anywhere else in Pandas. Moreover, unlike Boolean selection process, one can use the Python core operators and or not to build the logical condition instead of the operators ampersand, pipe, and tilde, which are used in Boolean mask indexing when we pass in the square bracket notation or the lock indexer, which further aids readability within the query. Now let's do an example using query method where we are going to filter a superstore dataset for sales greater than 100. How we can do that? It is very simple. We are going to call our data frame df, and then we will call our method query. Within the query method, we will pass the condition as a string. What does that mean is we'll call our variable sales, and then since we want to analyze sales greater than 100, we will use greater than operator, and then we'll pass the value 100. Let's use the head method and see the top 5 records. And you can see here that we have got a desired output of sales greater than 100 by using the query method. We can see here the values are 261.96, 731.94, 957.5775, and so on. Now let's say we want to filter the superstore dataset for sales between 100 and 120. How we can do that using query method? It is very simple. we are going to call the single quotes, and then we are saying 100 between 100 and 200 with and inclusive sales less than 200. Let's see the top five records. And you can see here, we have got a desired output. The sales values are between 100 and 200, 114.900, 124.200, 190.920, and so on. Don't you think so? The query method is more compact and readable than the Boolean mass indexing when we are using it with square bracket notation or with the lock indexer. Let's do another example where we would like to filter the superstore dataset where segment is consumer and sales is greater than 100. If you would like to reference a literal string within query, you need to surround it with double quotes, or else Pandas will attempt to use it as a column name. Let's see that. Let's call our data frame df with the query method. And then we are going to pass the condition within the single quotes. Here I'm saying segment equal to consumer and sales greater than 100. Let's use the head method and see the top five record. And you can see here, we have got a desired output where segment is equal to consumer and sales is greater than 100. If you are not going to use quotes around your literal string, then Pandas will assume that the value is column name and it is going to raise an error. It believes you are assessing a column name, consumer, which does not exist. Let's see that. Let me copy this example. And let me remove quotes from here. And you can see here, the error is undefined variable error. Name consumer is not defined. So you have to be very careful when you are using literal strings. You have to pass them within the quotes here. And this will work fine. Consumer for sales here, all greater than 100. So we have got the desired output. It is also possible to compare each value in one column with each value in another column using query method. Here we are going to do a sanity check to find out if there are any records in our data set where profitability is greater than sales. Logically, that is not possible. And if there are any bad data in our data set superstore, then we are going to filter out those records from our analysis. Let's do that example. We are calling our data frame df query, and we are saying profit is greater than sales. Fortunately, we do not have any bad records in our dataset, and we can continue with our analysis. And in this way, we can compare each value in one column with each value in another column using query method. One can use the in operator within the query method to check whether each value in a column is equal to one or more values or not. To use the in operator in the query method, we have to pass a list within the query string to contain all the values you would like to check. Let's do an example to see how we can use the in operator within the query method. Let's call our data frame df with the query method. And we are saying we want to analyze our data for east and west only. We are passing a list of strings which we would like to have in our data set for further analysis. And this is how one can use in operator within the query method. One can also invert the result of an in clause by placing the word not before it. Let us do that example also. Let me copy and paste the code. And what we are doing here, we are saying we do not want east and west data. We only want to analyze the data for north and south. And that is why we have placed a not operator here before in operator. And this is going to filter out east and west data from our data frame DF. Let's see that. And you can see here, we have successfully filtered out east and west data from our data set. And this is how one can check whether each value in a column is equal to one or more values by using in operator within your query method. It is possible to write arithmetic operation within query just as you would outside of it. Let's do an example and see how we can do that. Now, this example won't make much sense because we have sales and profit. And let's say we want to see if we do the addition of both the variables and it should be greater than 500. Let's see that example. I'm calling my data frame DF and then I'm calling the query method and I'm going to pass sales plus profit greater than 500. Let's use the head method and see if there are any records with it. So you can see here, there are some records where sales plus profit is greater than 500. As I said, this example doesn't make sense, but let's say if we have quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, and quarter four sales. Let's say a stakeholder wanted to see the sum of quarter three and quarter four sales greater than, let's say, $1 million. In that particular scenario, you can use this particular methodology and filter the data frame. The next example which we are going to do is that how we can reference variable name with the @ symbol. By default, all words within the query string attempt to reference a column name. You can, however, reference a variable name by preceding it with the @ symbol. What does that mean is, here in the query method, we assign the column name and then we put up a conditional operation by putting up the value. Like, for example, sales profit is greater than 500. However, we can also assign a custom variable name with its value. And that is going to be very helpful when you are writing a reproducible code, or let's say if you are building up a data pipeline and you want to change the values on the basis of loop or something else. In that particular case, @ symbol in query method is going to be very helpful for you. Let's do a certain example. Minimum sales equal to, let's say, 750. Now what I can do here, df.query sales greater than @ min underscore sales. Let me call the head method. And you can see here, we have filtered this data frame where sales is greater than 750 only. We have seen in the previous session that we can use index position to subset our data set. Similarly, we can use the word index to make comparison against the index as if it were a normal column. Let's see that and how we can filter our data frame using the index position. I'm calling the data frame DF and then index greater than 9000 and let's say sales greater than 500. And that's it. Let's use the head method to see the top 5 records. So you can see here we have filtered a data frame where the index position is greater than 9000 and the sales value is greater than 500. And see how simple it is and readable it is to use query method to filter the Pandas data frame. By this example, we come to an end of this session. In the next session, we are going to discuss about how we can sort a Pandas data frame. Till then, guys, take care and have a great day.